Hey everybody, it's me, Super Paul Games. Welcome back to Alter Ego. Our character is going into middle age now. Biography should be written by an acute enemy, Arthur James Balfour. Good for him. Alright, so what's new? Okay, we could go to college. Well, we don't want to, we already have our college degree. Yeah, we don't want to date anyone new. We're happily married with children. See if we can make another baby. Oh, I want more babies! Let's try one more. Alright, we'll try and come back again later to that. Let's do a family thing. A relative who you haven't seen in many years calls you up on the phone with a hard luck story. He needs approximately $5,000 in order to keep his house. You've heard that he has certain bad habits. Though, when he speaks with you, he sounds decent enough. Perhaps he really has fallen on hard times. He appeals to you for the loan, which he assures you he'll repay during the year. Oh, what the fuck? I'll lend him the money. You are very generous, but also a bit naive. As you discover, if you had a dollar for every excuse he comes up with, you would have been repaid. Unfortunately, you only get excuses, not the cash. You must have had some fantasy that he might strike it rich and repay you doubly or triply. Some fantasies can get very expensive. Well, you know what? It was just money. In the long run, it was just money. We at least did a decent thing by him. Alright, so we got our kids. Let us... we want to buy a house? Let's see. There's several types of houses. We can... an estate with stables and servant quarters? I don't want that. We can buy something nice, though. We've got three kids. Either a large... oh, God, that would be nice. A large nine-room colonial or a condominium townhouse. That's probably more reasonable, would be a condominium townhouse. Colonial sounds really nice, though, but... oh, fuck it. We'll go for the large nine-room colonial. Congratulations on the purchase of a new home. So, let's see. We are... what is that? 12,000? 120,000 in debt. We actually have 110,000, so we almost have enough money for it. Oh, we've got a nine-room colonial. We got a really nice house. So let's go pay back part of the loan. Let's pay back 100,000. So that means basically we had like a $100,000 down payment on the house. So we owe 20 grand yet, and we have about 10 grand in the bank. Man, that's almost paid off. That is amazing. I'm going to take my wife to celebrate. Rashid has decided that she would like to go back to college full-time to enrich her life. She claims to feel bored with her present life and craves the change. Her going back would cause you to have some more responsibilities. What if she hooks up with a college boy? What if she leaves me? What if I'm not enough for her? You would have to cook and clean up a bit more. You would also have fewer resources because of college costs, transportation costs, etc. Any loss of income if Brigitte stops working, what will you do? I'm going to encourage her. I was in this situation once in life before, and I encouraged the person to go back to college. If that's your dream, as long as it doesn't destroy the family, if you don't whore around at school, and I trust you, Brigitte, you're not like my mom was in the game. I'm going to encourage her to go to college if that's what makes her happy. And it's something that's good, you know, something's gonna make her smarter, give her more skills. It's not like she's like, I wanna develop a crack habit. That was very supportive of you. Over the course of her studies, you begin to see Brigitte less and less, and it seems that she has discovered a new life at school. Their new and younger friends, oh dear, both men and women, and lots of talk about things which either don't interest you or you don't understand. At this point you can why don't I just be honest and say I feel a little neglected. Rashid can understand this because she has felt a little neglected more than a few times. She had to tolerate those feelings as so must you. She has no plans to quit what she's doing because she enjoys it too much. I'm going to tolerate it then. I'm not going to be an asshole about it. If there's times as an entrepreneur starting my business, she's like, I felt a little... Okay, I'll tolerate it. It's a hard thing to accept, but eventually you realize how crucial college is to Brigitte. As a matter of fact, she does very well out of it. Eventually she graduates. How do you feel? I am proud of her. I am proud of her that... being a mother of three children and having to put up with me because I can get moody and need attention at times, that she went through and she did it and she didn't whore it up with the other people. And I'm proud of my wife. Yeah. That's very admirable of you. She's proud of herself as well. Now about graduate school? Ah! Damn it. Really, woman? Oh, we're doing well. Look how smart a guy is. Got Ulysses. Well, it's unnamed there. Oh, we have enough money to pay off our house now. Let us pay off our house. Can we only pay it off in 10,000 increments? So if I did that correctly, we've got a 9-room colonial house and no debt. And married to a college-educated sweetie. Let's do an intellectual thing. As you advance vocationally, you must leave your old responsibilities to various different people. On your next move forward, you are notified that a woman, oh, someone with a vagina, full of new ideas and dicks, I bet, techniques and strategies, is about to fill your old position. I'd fill Brigitte for more babies. She will not be placed without your approval. You interview her for her position. She comments that while she feels you did a good job where you were, she plans on doing a better one. She sees your skills in the area that you're about to leave as limited and old-fashioned due to no fault of your own, but times are changing. Now, I'm going to be calm and recommend she do the job. This is the case where you give someone enough rope to hang themselves. If she comes in and she's right, I'm going to look good. I'm going to look good because I'll be like, yep, If she comes in and fails, I'll be like, well, not my fault. Her and her newfangled things that she couldn't deal with the old time-tested ways. Do you like her style? Not really. In 3 months' time, everyone who comes in contact with her is complaining about that she's intolerable to work with. I'm going to call her in for a talk. You mention that she may be coming on too strong and that maybe she should take it easy. She tells you she absolutely disagrees. The people who can't work with her simply aren't willing to work. I'm going to let her keep talking. She continues pushing hard, and eventually the people around her accept her way. She is tremendously successful, and as a result, pushes you right out of the job. Oh, why don't I get to... What? But I... Are you serious? Don't I get credit? I helped... Does that mean I have to find a new job? I lost my fucking job. I took the risk on her. I'm like, we'll give her a chance to see if she can develop. She developed to be awesome. And I lost my job as an entrepreneur. All right, let's go get a new job. I know what part-time job. Let's pick. Let's do a researcher. I'd like to be a researcher. Why is that not good enough? All right. I wish they'd let you know what you needed ahead of time. Maybe be a lawyer? What? Why can't I get any of these? Technical? Then what was my engineering degree for? I don't want labor. I want either creative then or go to entrepreneur. Oh, I got a creative field. Oh, maybe I'm making videos with my VCR and stuff. I'm like, Brigitte, it ended up being even better. I lost my job, but now I'm making fun films for everybody. Horror films. Can we make another baby to celebrate? I want some babies. I'm taking my wife out. I got a new job doing creative things. Life's good, eh? So it worked out well. That lady got better for the company, and then I don't have to work at that shit job anymore. Late at night, while you're still awake and Brigitte is sleeping, you watch her lying peacefully, a wide smile on your face. Stroke her hair gently and whisper, I love you. She looks up at you, glassy-eyed and half-awake. She puts her arms across your chest and squirms into the comfortable spot between your arm and shoulder. She whispers, I love you, Esteban. And falls into a deep sleep. What? Esteban? I am not named Esteban. I'm going to mention to her in the morning. Maybe she was just having a dream. Since you can control your hostility and frustration rather well, you're not... Oh, that'd be cool, because if you can't, you probably just scream out there. It's a good thing I've mellowed out as my guy got older. You nonchalantly ask Brigitte if she remembers blurting out Esteban's name in her sleep last night. She says she doesn't remember anything like that and laughs it off as being silly. Mentioned that she was looking quite peaceful during her sleep, which sparks an association. Oh yeah, I do remember having a kind of kinky dream last night, she teases. I'm going to ask about the dream. Brigitte thinks you're being ridiculous. How can anyone remember that much detail about any dream? All she can remember is that Esteban had dark hair and a mustache. Before she can say anything else, she begins to giggle. What's so funny? She says nothing and begins to giggle hysterically. Come on, tell me what's so funny. Well, if you really want to know, uncontrollable laughter. He had a huge... Oh, God. Please continue. Please say huge mustache. A huge sombrero. Oh, good night. Oh, Brigitte, I love you. I love that we can be married and have all those children, and I'd still feel insecure enough to be like, no, I want you to love me best. Much better than my parents' in-game parents' relationship. Your father's eyesight is beginning to fail him, and his reflexes are not as quick as they used to be. Oh, good, I can feed him mud again! He won't know. However, he refuses to turn in his driver's license. Although he rarely drives, when he does, he is an absolute menace. You're sure he will wind up killing either himself or an innocent person. I'm going to be sympathetic, but I'm going to tell him he needs to give up his license. No, I'm going to empathize and try to reason with him sympathetically. You try to explain that he might hurt himself. Nonsense! What's the matter with you? Do you think I'm a child? I can take care of myself? Empathy does not always soothe the savage breast. Your father feels as if an important decision were being made for him. This is very upsetting to older people. After spending a lifetime being responsible for your children, it is hard to accept their attempts to be responsible for you. He doesn't give up the license. Great. My family is such a pain in the ass. Parents, my kids, and wife. Amazing! Amazing! Look at all this money we're putting away. Let's go buy something. Let's buy a library of books for the kids in case they, you know, they want to get educated or Brigitte wants to read. New books, 25 per purchase. Yeah, I want to buy them. I would like to pay for it in cash. Made my guy smarter, apparently. He's already, like, maxed out on smartness. Let's do some social things. You have seen your friend John and his wife Marcia. Wait, didn't I date a Marcia once? Socially for a long time. They have a very peculiar relationship. Marcia insists on controlling every aspect of John's life. Somebody's pussy whipped. One day when you're talking to John, he confesses that about 3 years ago he began seeing another woman. One is beautiful, kind, gentle, and loving. He has been thinking about leaving Marcia for this other woman, but is unsure if he can. Wow. How long have they been married? Like, if that was before he was married, I'd be comfortable. If it was after they were married that he was seeing this other chick, then I would not be comfortable. I guess I'll be comfortable, but not give him any direct advice. The sound of breaking glass punctuates your otherwise relaxing afternoon. You're glad you don't have to deal with any of this. Yeah, it ain't my problem. I'm going back to Brigitte and sex her up. Try to make another baby. One more time. I'm enjoying middle-aged sex. We're having a lot of sex, and that's a good thing. You have a small appliance that is broken, but it can definitely be fixed with a little tinkering. I'll tinker with it. My guy's got an engineering degree. He's going to be like, yeah, I got an engineering degree. I totally want to fix this. Hell yeah. There's a loose screw that is hanging precariously by its lip in a very hard-to-reach place. Is it in my butt? As you reach the screwdriver near the screw, it slips out of reach. I'll turn it upside down and shake it a bit. You can hear a screw bouncing around. It sounds like it'll drop out soon, but remains aside. I'll keep shaking it. Screw bounces out onto the table, and then down onto a part of the floor that camouflaged a small army. That could camouflage a small army. Screw is virtually invisible. Well, I'm going to look around for it. Ouch, you found it! It struck directly in the bottom of your bare hand! Small red dead blood comes to the surface. I'm going to continue trying to repair it. At this point, I am too far in. Brigitte's going to be like, we can get a new one. No! No! It's drawing my blood. I will fix it. Eventually, you must turn the appliance upside down in order to get the screw back in. Crash! The inside of the appliance rained down all over the table, chipping and scratching everything in sight. The appliance is now irreparable. I'm going to swear at it. Fuck, bag! You're just like Dad's lawnmower when I was a kid. Now, I can see this has been a frustrating experience for you. You did give it the old college try, which suggests you have perseverance. The appliance got its just desserts, right? After all, it's dead. It will never torture you again. Man, the engineering degree is not paid out off for us at all. Let's buy some more stuff. Be a little materialistic. Let's buy an automobile. I can't believe we didn't have one. Must have used mass transit. There are five types of automobile. I want to buy a luxury prestige car. I will pay for it with cash. Living up a little bit, see? We got a prestiged card, a kick-ass... I want a nine-room colonial. Yeah, we're kind of living... I hate to get materialistic, but it's nice to have those. Hey, wife, you want to make some more babies? Sexy times in your vagina. Nah, that was still nice. Is that what I say after the sex with her? Yeah, I know we didn't make a baby, but that was still nice sexing you. I'm too old for this episode. Oh man! At a carnival, a friend tries to convince you to have your cards read by Madame Natasha. I will skeptically see the medium. You step inside a dark room. Medium Natasha looks more like a large Natasha. It fills most of the space. Don't eat me! You notice that she has a kind face and a gentle voice. The fee for reading is $50. Kish only, please, darkin. Darlink, whatever. Yeah, I'll continue. She got 50 bones. I thought you were skeptical. Oh, well, it's your money. Thank you, darling. Let's see. The voices of evil. They're very powerful. They are kneeling being spelled. The spell will rid you of them for a long time. Cost of the spell is minimal.
$500?
I am not paying $500 to get rid of some fake spell from a con woman. Good thing. At $50, you're just a bit gullible. At $100, you are a sucker. At $500, I would have tried to sell you a nice piece of real estate near the Florida Everglades. Fucking con artist bullshit. Hey, wife, I'm going to take you out on a date. You have been an awesome wife. Your wife has an interesting habit, which she managed has displayed many times over the years you've been married. Every time the two of you go to dinner... Oh, she picks up the food in your dish? What? It's one thing when she smacks on her own fingers, but don't be touching my food. I hate when people do that. I hate when I get a plate of food, I'm like, and then they try to mess with... No, get off my food dish! If you wanted something, you should have told me, I would have got extra for you. When I get something for me, I get just enough for just how much I want. Tonight, the two of you are with very special friends. Moments after you sit down to eat, she spears an appetizer from your dish and it pops in her mouth. We've been married for a long time, long enough to give her a dirty look. I could make a funny joke about it, but that's passive-aggressive and rude. I could ignore it, but I'm not that big of a person. I could say something firm and polite, but that seems demeaning. No, Brigitte, no. So I'm just going to give her a dirty look. Even though you're typically very gentle, there's no way that you can give a dirty look to your wife in public in a socially acceptable way. Instead of just your wife doing something tacky now, you both have done something socially inappropriate. Social sphere goes down. Well, it was rude of her to steal my food, for the love of God. We make enough money. We have a luxury car, a colonial house. She's got a college degree. She can buy her own damn food. She doesn't have to eat mine. I swear. Ooh, another episode of sexualness. A longtime friend and confidant tells you he's having an unusual sexual problem with his wife. Seems that he can no longer get or maintain an erection like he used to. I'm going to be sympathetic and encourage him to see a doctor. He returns to tell you the doctor told him that his problem might have been caused by high blood pressure medication he's been taking. He feels relieved. Now there's only one small difficulty. You notice you are having the same type of trouble. What will you do? I'm going to go see a doctor. The doctor gives you a checkup and tells you that there's nothing wrong with your system. Oh, it's anxiety. Performance anxiety will do that. Anxiety can certainly affect sexual functioning. Perhaps when your friend told you he was having difficulties, it made you so anxious that you developed some of your own. Oh, good. Just to practice it, we better go have some sex right now. Sex and my wife. I don't think we're going to have any more babies. I'm glad we helped our friend, though. You are on a sightseeing cruise. You hear a cry and see a small boy fall over and rail into the water. There doesn't seem to be enough time to call for help because the boat is moving quickly. Fucking A, I'm going in after him. If it was my boy, I'd have to. Like, now that I have children, I have enough empathy where I have to go in. Hopefully I don't drown. Calmness is a trait that is central to your personality. In this instant, you use it to react quickly and efficiently. As you enter the water, you spot the boy about 25 yards to your left. I'm going to call out to the boy. That was a good idea. The sound of your voice is comforting and helps orient the boy in the proper direction. Eventually you get to the boy. As you clutch him into your arms, you see a small motorized raft from the sightseeing boat heading towards you. Your heroic efforts help save the boy's life. The next day, the newspaper and television reports chronicle your heroic deed. You're quite a remarkable person. I wrote a book and I saved a life. I bet my wife is going to sex me now. Hey, Brigitte, let's have sex. Sexing it up. I don't care if we had a baby or not. That's the going to sex and all thing. In fact, I love her so much, I'm taking her out on another date. Your wife has become interested in photography and has signed up for photography class at the local high school. Her assignment for this week is candid photography. As a result of this, everything you do at home is accompanied by a familiar click where click. As long as she's not taking pictures of me, like, whacking it or sexing her, it's all good. Yesterday morning, she snapped you just as you were rising and called the picture Squirrel's Nest Surprise. One afternoon, while you were alone in the house, sitting on the toilet, the telephone rings. Oh, God. Pick up the phone. A representative from a famous women's magazine calls to congratulate you on your sense of humor and your desire to see your wife succeed. Squirrel's Nest Surprise was entered in a photo contest and your wife won first prize? $1,000? Brigitte gives you half of it for being such a good model? I think at that point, me and her would have to have a talk. I'd be like, Brigitte, I love you, but before you send pictures of me to magazines, please at least get my permission. You would have to from other models, most likely, so... Oh, and that's the end of middle age. Man, I can't believe middle age was so much fun. Your family life has been good. During this phase of your life, your body doesn't always respond the way your mind would like it to. A sore back after a hard day work or a sore feet and legs after a long walk are not uncommon. In general, you're not very healthy. You know, the plus part, though, is we lost our old job and we got a job where we're going to do something fun and creative. You know, we got a bunch of cool kids. Our wife's awesome. Life's good. We got a kick-ass car. So you can, like, drag race with kids. We're like, fuck you, I just torched you. We got our cool colonial house. Fortunately, you don't have to worry about drugs or alcohol ruining your health. That's not like real life. Socially, you're doing quite well. I hope that you and Brigitte are enjoying your lives together. We're so happy. Now that Esteban is gone. Now, regarding your emotional and personality development, you're a very trustworthy person. Even though we all have our secrets, you're doing a very good job keeping your wilder side under control. You seem to have negotiated your midlife crisis without becoming depressed. It's kind of like me in real life. I guess it's because I'm in the creative field, is that if I have a true midlife crisis, I'll probably become a lawyer and accountant. Because, like, up to now, it's like, I've made cartoons, I've got to act, I've got to be an entertainer. Not a good one, necessarily. So if I have a midlife crisis, it's going to be something really boring. I need to be a lawyer, an accountant. You can be sensible and understanding. Usually cool, calm, and collected. See that, Mom? If you were alive today, you would see I'm a success. You got on my ass about Mohawk when you wouldn't help me when I needed a poop. People see you as an extremely wise person. They rely on you often for advice and are pleased with the results they get from interacting with you. The next phase of life is full of mixed blessings. You may feel old and lonely some days and cheerful and strong on others. Our society certainly has its share of prejudice against older folks, but you can have rich and rewarding experiences despite this. You'll have your chance to thumb your nose at people who think you are too old to live it up a little. After all, you were doing most of the things and enjoying them long before people were toilet trained. Which brings us to... old age. I'm guessing this is probably the last phase of the game, which I'm looking forward to. So far we've had... Though we had a troubled childhood with very shitty, negligent parents, our character has overcome that and, in fact, become a much better parent than his own were. I don't know, maybe it'd be different if we played it from the perspective of his children, whatever. Welcome to old age. It is not white hair that engenders wisdom, and, he's dead. Good for him. What's that? Sunset? After a long but very relaxing day, with a deep sigh, you climb into bed and sink into the warm, cushiony fabric. As you drift off, feelings of intense serenity and well-being overwhelm you. Pleasant images of childhood visit with sweet memories of mom and dad, school, and growing up. Sweet memories of mom and dad, really? The rest, yeah! The memories flash by your mind's eye with startling reality. The smell of school on your first day. The outfit your very first girlfriend wore on your first date. You recall places you haven't visited for in years. Picture-perfect detail. Or imperfect picture-perfect detail. Friends and neighbors who have gone on greet you. They're filled with excitement to see you, though you soon realize they're not communicating their joy in words. It's almost as if this will go on forever. That's it! I died! That was the beginning of old age! Well, I guess I'm not gonna live to see grandkids! I'm like, alright, old age! I'm dead. Well, everybody, that was Alter Ego. I think it was Alyssa is Swedish suggested that. This has been a lot of fun to play. If I remember, there should be the link to this video, or this game, in all the descriptions. It's free to play. It's a lot of fun. I'm almost interested to go see if it would be different. I shouldn't have clicked it on Sunset right away. So much for my old age. I'm going to retire. I'm dead. It happens though in life. It happens. I believe it happened to my grandfather's first full day of retirement, I believe, is when he died. So that's what happened to us. But we had a rich, wonderful life. It's a good thing we packed so much into the years we did with our lovely wife, Brigitte, who's now a widow, and she'll miss us. Hopefully she doesn't find a real Esteban. No one can replace us. We had a lot of fun. Thanks for watching, everybody, and it's kind of an abrupt end, but sometimes life is an abrupt end. I'll see y'all next time.